It's late at night. You got a Jones in for some creamy, satisfying almond milk. And you're thinking to yourself, why am I spending so much money on low-grade almond milk when I probably could make it at home? It's not as hard as you think, and you can be creative.
So what do we got going on here, Jessica?
We have some soaked almond, soaked for 12 hours and then rinsed. And we have some dates and coconut, having been soaked in separate water. The nut water, we do not keep the soaking water. You could feed it to your plants if you'd like. I also added a dash of sea salt. Helps bring out certain flavors and throws a few more nutrients in the mix. All goodness. Now, I'm gonna put this in the blender on low. The blender is the most nerve-wracking part for me. So I'm glad you're here with me, world. So I was thinking about maybe putting a banana or a half a banana into it. I like to break them by hand sometimes. In she goes. Then you take the jar and you fill it with water. So even though the blender is intimidating, it's a key component to this.
Wow.
We're not trying to liquefy it. But we are trying to break all the nuts apart to extract the best goodness from them. You know, the juicer could do it on its own, but the blender makes it that much easier. So, because we're into sharing and caring, we're gonna help our machines work together. Here we are working with the Omega juicer. Fruits and vegetables, and apparently nuts. Now your rinse jar. Put a little bit of water in that original, also all into saving good water and nutrients, appreciating every little bit. Splash that in there and let it get all the last of the particulates extracted into the proper order. Diverging essence, elemental power. Shakti, 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 shakti. So as you can see, we have the juice coming out on this side. The almond coconut date milk. And the black stuff on top is some vanilla. So again, that was that super nutritional deliciousness we spoke of at the beginning. So this is coming out to be quite a bit of milk. And original jar, just rinse it out so you don't have too much pulp in there, and it looks like we're gonna hit it right on the button. Optional step for some, if desired, is a final straining. The bowl you use to soak the almonds can just go right back in there. I like the pulp. I generally like to do this. Let that strain out. Give it a good little shake there. So again, this is half, only half a cup of soaked almonds and a cup and a half of dates and coconut, salt, a little bit of vanilla, part of a banana, and a little dose of love. It's so satisfying. I hope you'll take the time to have that adventure.